All right, welcome. I'm Tavleen and I am the Chief of Marketing at excelplugins.com, and we'll be talking about Sales Triggers, which is an excelplugins.com product. And if you want more information, feel free to head out to excelplugins.com/WooCommerce Sales Triggers. All right, so I'm in a store that sells beauty related products and I saw this really interesting form here. Now, as you can notice that this particular product is actually out of stock. So instead of just giving a very flat out message that the product is out of stock, what they've done is they've actually put here an email collection box here, which asks you to leave your email ID so that they can notify you when the product is back. And I thought this was such an interesting technique. Why? Well, because it helps, it increases customer loyalty, right? Because when they're leaving their email ID and they are wanting you to get back to them, they have more chances of actually converting. They have more chances of going back, and whenever your item is restocked, right? Because they have committed to the fact that they want you to notify them, right? This also becomes an opportunity for you to collect email IDs. Like, now mostly when you give a, show a pop-up, people might just cross it off and exit it and probably just keep continue browsing on your store. But when they willingly leave their email ID and voluntarily want you to get in touch, then of course you can add their email ID to your subscriber list as well and send them not just notification when you restock the item, but also about your offers, about your special deals, about fresh arrivals and all of that. Right, so it's an interesting opportunity to collect email IDs, and of course the product is out of stock, so you have converted that that into an opportunity, which is great, right? So now I'm going to show you how you as a WooCommerce store owner can configure something like this on your product page and collect people's email IDs on your out of stock items on automation, right? So sounds like a great plan. Let me now take you behind the scenes and show you how it is actually done. So now I'm on the back end and I have selected Excel plugins, Excel WooCommerce sales triggers, and from the drop down here I've selected low stock because we're talking about the low stock trigger here, right? Now here we've got three display options. One is the commitment text. It is for items which are in stock, so it gives simple message in stock, right? And you have the option to change the color here, so which I've made it as green. So whenever the item is in stock, it will just display in a green color that it is in stock. The second option is the scarcity text option. Right now, this is when the item is actually just about to run out or just 4 or 5 pieces are left. Now you can specify that number over here, like it's 5 in this case, right? So when the items left are 5, then it will automatically switch into the scarcity mode, right? So from in stock, it will start showing hurry up, we're selling fast, only 5 items left, almost gone, right? So you have the option to edit this text because this is completely editable. The next thing is this item is out of stock. Now over here I'm going to teach you how you can actually configure that form here, the email collection form here, whenever your product is actually out of stock, right? And I will show you how to generate a form and then create a short code for it, and then we will come back here and paste it, right? So let's go back to forms. Now I'll just a quick word here. So you can install any forms. You could install Ninja Forms, Contact Form 7. Well, I have got Gravity Forms, so I'm going to make use of that, and I will show you how you can actually configure a form using Gravity Forms, right? So we will go to new form. Okay, we're on a new form. Now what I've done is I've already created this form, right? So that I could quickly take you through this, but it's really simple to create a form. It's simple drag and drop. So for example, if I would just drag and drop the email part here, right, that ways, it will actually automatically show me a form with the email field, right? So since that is already here, I'm just going to get rid of this. So that's it. Right now here you have the option to change the field label and the description, right? So like here I've got leave your email below, want to get notified when you restock, when we restock this item, enter your best email, we'll give you a shout out, right? So these are some options that you have, like appearance, which is the placeholder text, what you want, what you can change this, edit this text, right? And then this is the description placement, so if you want it below the inputs or above the inputs. Now I have added here, I've written, so I've selected above inputs, right? And that's it. So with that, you have this form ready. Now you can go to form settings, right? And from here, Yeah. So this is the form title, this is the form description, and you have the option to change the CTA button text, right? So I've written here, yes, I want to get notified. So a really persuasive text, right? And a very personalized message, right? And then we can go on confirmations. In the confirmation, what we can do is we can actually edit this to write whatever text we want, right? So thank you, now sit back and continue shopping. We'll let you know once the item is restocked, right? So that is what I've written for leaving a confirmation message once a person actually submits his email ID or her email ID on my product detail page, right? And then here's the notification. So notification is how I want to get informed about the form submission. So now we've got this form. Now what we're going to do is we're going to simply go and add new post. We're not going to actually add new post, but we're just going to pick up the short code. So we'll select the form, get notified on restock, display form title, display description, right? So title true, description true, we've got the short code here. We're going to simply copy this. All right, so now we've copied the short code and we're in the low stock trigger, like I was just discussing with you, the commitment text, scarcity text, and the out of stock text. Now instead of saying this item is out of stock, we are gonna now replace this completely with the gravity form short code, right? So we have the gravity form short code now. The color I want that it should be red, right? So out of stock text, because it is a notification that we're giving. So I would like it to be red. You can change it to whatever you like. And then we're gonna simply update this. So now let me refresh it and show you how it will appear on the product detail page, right? So yeah, here we go. Get notified on restock, leave your email below, and then you've got the placeholder text here, and then yes, I want to get notified, right? So you can leave an email ID, you can test it. So let me just show you. So I'm going to leave tavleen@gmail.com, and yes, I want to get notified, right? So that's it. This is the confirmation text. Thank you. Now sit back and continue shopping. We'll let you know once the item is restocked. So it is such a great opportunity for you to actually not just collect email IDs, but also to build customer loyalty, right? Because when they're leaving their email ID, they want to get notified, right? So they've actually raised their hand and said that I want to receive email from you, right? And they are genuinely interested in the product. So that's it. So if you liked what you just saw, I would encourage you to head out to excelplugins.com/WooCommerce sales triggers. And then just go ahead and explore this. It not just allows you to actually show the items left in stock and with the scarcity message, the commitment message, also allows you to do a lot of other things. For example, show countdown timer to drum up urgency, show the savings that your shoppers can be making to trigger loss aversion, then share the most recent sales activity to activate social proof, then show your commitment towards your products and towards your store through a bulletproof guarantee box, right? So there are more things that you can do. That we've got 7 psychology backed sales triggers which will help you increase your sales. So this is the before and after. So go ahead and explore this, and yeah, you have the option to view the demo or to make the purchase and to install it on your WooCommerce store right away. So I hope you enjoyed that, and if you did, do let me know in the comment box below, because I thoroughly enjoyed delivering this little presentation to you and to tell you what all options are there so that you can increase your sales. Happy selling. Thank you. I'll see you in the next video.